Now that I've explained the theory of K-means clustering to you, I'm going to show you how to use the scikit-learn implementation to deploy it in your own studies. So I start over here at Google, and I find that there's a whole page on clustering in scikit-learn. The first thing that I notice when I get to this page is that there are many types of clustering besides just K-means clustering. So all of these different columns right here are different types of clustering. We won't go into all of these. Instead, I want to use this page to navigate to the Kmeans documentation that you can get a little bit of a better idea of how this is handled in scikit-learn. So here's a list of all the different clustering methods that I have. And here, the first item on the list we see is Kmeans and some summary information about the algorithm. So one of the parameters that you have to define for Kmeans is the number of clusters. Remember, we had to say at the outset how many clusters we want to look for. And this is one of the things that can be most challenging, actually, about using Kmeans is deciding how many clusters you want to try. Then it gives us some information about the scalability, which basically tells us how the algorithm performs as you start to have lots and lots of data or lots of clusters. A use case, which gives us a little bit of information that this is good for general purpose when you have clusters that have even number of points in them and so on. And last, that the way that K-means clustering works is based on the distances between the points. So very consistent with what we've seen so far. Let's dig in a little bit deeper. Now we're at the K-means documentation page, and there are three parameters in particular that I want to call your attention to. The first and most important one is n clusters. The default value for n clusters is 8, but of course we know that the number of clusters in the algorithm is something that you need to set on your own based on what you think makes sense. This might even be a parameter that you play around with. So you should always be thinking about whether you actually want to use this default value or if you want to change it to something else. I can guarantee you that you're mostly going to want to change it to something else. The second parameter that I want to call your attention to is max iter equals 300. Remember that when we're running K-means clustering, we have an iteration that we go through as we're finding the clusters, where we assign each point to a centroid, and then we move the centroid. Then we assign the points again, we move the centroids again. And each one of those assign and move steps is an iteration of the algorithm. And so max iter actually says, how many iterations of the algorithm do you want it to go through? 300 will usually be a very reasonable value for you. In fact, most of the time, I would guess that it's going to terminate before it gets to this maximum number. But if you want to have a finer level of control over the algorithm and how many times it goes through that iteration process, this is the parameter that you want. And then the last parameter that I'll mention, another one that's very important, is the number of different initializations that you give it. Remember, we said that K-means clustering has this challenge that depending on exactly what the initial conditions are, you can sometimes end up with different clusterings. And so then you want to repeat the algorithm several times so that any one of those clusterings might be wrong, but in general, the ensemble of all the clusterings will give you something that makes sense. That's what this parameter controls, is basically how many times does it initialize the algorithm? How many times does it come up with clusters? You can see that by default, it goes through it 10 times. If you think for some reason that your clustering might be particularly prone to bad initializations or challenging initializations, then this is the parameter that you want to change. Maybe bump the number of initializations up to a higher number. But again, just to reiterate, of all those parameters, number of clusters is definitely the one that's the most important and that you should be playing around with and thinking really hard about the most.